Hello, this is Vern, and if you hate the feeling of showing up needy with a man that you're attracted to, on today's video, I'm gonna show you how to stop that once and for all. Hello, this is Vern. Welcome to another edition of VernMendez.com, a space where I share with conscious, ambitious, heart-centered women how you can attract the man you want and enter the relationship you've been seeking without the need for gimmicks, manipulation, or crazy techniques. Now, if you show up needy, the feeling of neediness, which we all hate, with men that you feel attracted to, first thing I want you to do is to give yourself some kindness. And here's why, because there's so much shame attached to the feeling of this person shows up attached really quickly or shows up really needy. And the last thing I want is for you to beat yourself up for something that you haven't yet learned how to overcome. The good news is this can be something that you overcome. This is not something that you're bound to repeat for the rest of your life. The bad news is you have to change your approach, that's all. But you have to be kind in the process. First, there's four pillars that maintain this feeling of neediness. And if you understand what they are and you do something about it, then you don't have to show up that way. First pillar that creates a feeling of neediness is the feeling of intensity. Here's what I mean. When you connect to a man that you feel highly attracted to, the chemicals firing in your brain are incredibly strong, meaning the level of intensity could be level 10, 11 out of a 0 to 10. Now, compare that to what you're experiencing on your day-to-day life. For most human beings, the level of intensity in life is not nearly as high as the level of intensity connected to with somebody of the opposite sex that they feel super attracted to. So because of that, if you want to stop showing up needy with men, you need to find out avenues in your life to increase, go up in level of intensity so that the contrast between you connecting to a man and you connecting to your life is not between day and night. An analogy would be if you have been in the desert for a couple of weeks without eating, and maybe you ran out of water 3 days ago, the first thing that shows up for you, crappy water tainted with poop, or a McDonald's hamburger, which I think is kind of one of the worst in the world, and you eat that, you'll say yes to that because you're hungry and you're starving and you're thirsty, right? But if you have just gone to your best favorite restaurant, for example, and you ate your favorite meal, well, somebody shows up with the same tainted poop water and McDonald's hamburger, very easily you'll say no because you're satiated with good, nutritious food, or at least better tasting food, right? So the same thing is true with men. If your experience of vibrancy in life is low, then any guy you connect with high intensity will feel a huge increase from what you're used to. And it's gonna be very high for you to say no or not show up needy, because if that goes away, then you feel bored, you don't feel as excited, your life is not as intense. So the first solution for that is you need to increase your intensity in life. Second pillar that creates this feeling of attachment quickly and yucky feeling of neediness with men is the feeling of scarcity, right? Why? Because if in your mind you have a mindset that says, there's no men out there, and you finally connect with one guy, then your mind will say, well, this is your one and only opportunity to make this happen. And if you don't make it happen, God knows how many years will go by before you experience this again. So I'm gonna go all in, I'm gonna do whatever it takes to not lose this, including showing up needy, because you don't wanna lose the man, right? So that's the second thing that needs to be accounted for. So what's the alternative to feeling this feeling of scarcity is creating more options, figuring out ways for you to connect with more men, both online and offline, so that when one guy who's great shows up, you don't have just one guy that you're connecting with. Many women date in such a way that when they connect to a guy that they like, they make him the de facto boyfriend, even though he's not being vetted or anything. So if you have more options, if you're connecting with more men, if you don't date exclusively until the conditions are ripe for both of you to become exclusive, then if that guy doesn't call you, if he doesn't message you, guess what? You have two more options that you're connecting with. But if that guy is your one option, if you're putting all your eggs in one basket from a guy that you don't even really know, then it's really hard for you not to feel needy, because that's your only solution to your love dilemma. Third pillar that makes it hard for some women to stop showing needy is boundaries. Why? Because if you don't set some strong boundaries early on, including physical boundaries, intimate boundaries, the likelihood that you'll feel attached way sooner goes through the roof. Meaning, you connect with a guy, you feel like he's a great guy, you start thinking lots of good thoughts about him, you have sex with him. Guess what's gonna happen? You're gonna feel way more attached to him than if you didn't have sex. Or you maybe don't have sex, but you get close to it. Again, the more physical your connection with him is, the more likely it is you'll be attached early on. So set some strong boundaries so that you can evaluate with more time and with more objectivity who the hell he really is. And so that you don't feel as attached as quickly as you maybe have in the past and be able to make better decisions about it. Fourth pillar that makes it hard for women to show up in a way that's not needy is projection. Why is projection a challenging thing? Because the moment you meet a guy that seems to fit the bill, you might start telling yourself, he's the one. I've never met anyone like him. He's the most gentle guy I've ever met. You start saying shit to yourself that's not true, but seems true and feels really good, right? So here's the alternative to that. Create a hypothesis scenario where instead of saying, I met the most amazing man I've ever met in my life, you say, well, I think I met an amazing man. Or instead of saying, he's the most kind soul you could ever imagine, it's like, he appears to be a kind soul. Why is that? This is not just a play on words, it's true. The less you make your initial assessments the law of what things are, the more you can make it a hypothesis, the more you're able to maybe navigate around it. And when new evidence is presented that shows you the guy is different, you can pivot and you can create a new idea. But if you're set on this projection and you then attach yourself because you have sex early on or get physical early on, and then you add to that the scarcity principle saying he's the only one and you don't have more options, and then the intensity in your life is not great, that's the ripe, perfect storm for you to feel super attached and super needy with a guy. The alternative is do what I'm sharing with you right now. Go up in intensity, create more options, set boundaries so your attachment is not as strong at the beginning, and base your thoughts and ideas instead of projecting them as universal laws, as a hypothesis. Hope this is helpful, useful, and insightful to you. If it is, I'm gonna ask you to do one thing. If you wanna learn how to step into the most powerful relationship you've been in, and you don't know how to do it, I created a masterclass that you can sign up for, and it's free. The first link on the description of this video will allow you to enter your name and email and start watching that training right away. If you like this video, click like or thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, click the little bell if you want to be notified of new episodes, and last but not least, if you have been watching my videos and other people's videos, you've been reading books, doing the law of attraction, doing projection boards, mantras, meditations, and you still don't have what you want, there's a strong sense of possibility that there's a better approach for you. If you want to find out if I can help you, hold you by the hand to help you enter that relationship that you want, second link under the description of this video will allow you to apply to work with me. If I'll read your application, if we're a fit, we'll connect, and then let you know how that plays out, if we can work together to make this happen. Thank you so much for connecting with me, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.